हिस्ट्री चैप्टर 8 स्टेट्स आफ्टर द मौर्य एम्पायर पॉइंट्स टू बी डिस्कस्ड 8.1 द शुंगा डायनेस्टी 8.2 इंडो ग्रीक किंग्स 8.3 कुशाना किंग्स 8.4 द गुप्ता डायनेस्टी 8.5 द वर्धान डायनेस्टी 8.6 पावर्स इन नॉर्थ ईस्ट इंडिया First point, 8.1, the Shunga dynasty explanation. After the Emperor Ashoka, Maurya power started decreasing. The last Maurya emperor was Brihadratha. The Maurya general Pushyamitra Shunga fought and killed Brihadratha and became the king of Shunga dynasty. So students, I hope this point is clear to you. 8.2 Indo-Greek kings. The Greek kings who ruled the northwest of Indian continent were known as Indo-Greek kings. The coins of Greek kings had great importance in ancient India. They had a tradition of putting the picture of the king on one side and the deity on the other side. This tradition of making such coins also started in India. The famous Indo-Greek king was Menander. He discussed Buddhist philosophy with Buddhist Bhikkhu Nagasena. Menander is also known as Milinda. The question he discussed with Nagasena was led to the creation of a book named Milind Panha. Panha is a Pali script word. It means questions. So students, I hope this point is clear to you. 8.3 Kushana kings. Explanation. India was always attacked by tribes oftenly. One of the tribe was Kushana from Central Asia. They established their empire in the northwestern region and in Kashmir in 1st century CE. The Kushana kings were first to start making gold coins. They started putting images of Gautam Buddha and different Indian gods on the coins. Kushana king Kanishk started extending the empire. Let us know more about Kushana King Kanishk. Emperor Kanishk extended his empire from Kabul to Varanasi. In excavations, gold and copper coins have been found made by Emperor Kanishk. The fourth Buddhist council was done in Kashmir. He established a city of Kanishkpur in Kashmir. There is a village in Kashmir. Its name is Kampur near Srinagar. It is believed that it could be Kanishkpur. During Kanishk reign, there was a well-known poet Ashwa Ghosh. He wrote the text Buddha Charitra and Vajra Suchi. The famous Vaidya Chark was also from Kanishk court. So students, I hope this point is clear to you. Let us see the next point. 8.4 Gupta dynasty. Explanation. At the end of 3rd century, Gupta dynasty started to rise. The Guptas were in power for 3 centuries. Sri Gupta was the founder king of Gupta dynasty. Samudragupta and Chandragupta II was the other kings of Gupta dynasty. Let us know who was Samudragupta. Explanation. Gupta empire was established by Chandragupta Maurya I. His son was Samudragupta. He defeated small neighboring kingdoms and extended his empire. Gupta Empire began to grow from Assam to Punjab. He conquered eastern coast of Kanchi in Tamil Nadu. Due to his victories, he was very famous everywhere. So, the kings of northwestern frontiers and kings of Sri Lanka made friendship with Samudragupta and signed many treaties. There is a pillar inscription in Prayagraj. It describes the conquest and victories of Samudragupta. This inscription is known as Allahabad Prashasti. It is also known as Prayag Prashasti. Samudragupta was a expert veena player. He minted coins with variety of images carved on it. In one of the coin, he is seen playing veena. His name is mentioned on that coin. Let us know about Chandragupta II. Explanation: after Samudragupta, his son Chandragupta II took the throne and ruled the Gupta kingdom. Chandragupta extended his empire to northwest. He also won and merged Malwa, Gujarat and Saurashtra. He made good relationship with South Indian kings. They were known as Vakataka rulers. Chandragupta married his daughter Prabhavati to Rudrasen II in South and made his relationship strong in South. There is an iron pillar in Delhi at a place named Mehrauli. That pillar is not rusted in the last 1500 years. This pillar is an excellent example of the skills of the people or the workers of ancient India. The inscription on the pillar says the name of a king called Chandra. It is believed to be the pillar made during Chandragupta II. During Gupta dynasty, a Bauddha bhikkhu named Fa Yan came to India. He wrote many information about India in his writing. He has stated in his writing that Gupta emperor had efficient administration system. So students, I hope this point is clear to you. Let us see 8.5, the Vardhan dynasty. Explanation: after the Gupta power began to decline, many other states were seen in north of India. The Vardhan dynasty was one of them. Prabhakar Vardhan was the king. He was from Thanesar near Delhi. King Prabhakar Vardhan was the founder of Vardhan dynasty. His son Harshvardhan expanded the kingdom from Nepal in north to Narmada in south, from Assam in east, from Gujarat in west. He had good relations with Raja Bhaskara Varman from Kampur. Kampur means it is today's Assam. He had friendly relations with Emperor of China. He also sent his ambassador to China for promoting trade. The capital of Harshvardhan's empire was Kanauj. Trade started progressing during his reign. He spent a large amount of revenue for the common welfare of the people of his kingdom. Every 5 years, he will distribute all his earned wealth among the people. There was a poet in his court. His name was Banbhat. Banbhat wrote Harshacharitra, that is a biography on Emperor Harshvardhan. This biography says about the life and achievements of Harshvardhan. He was the follower of Buddhism. He equally respected other religions also. Banbhat wrote 3 Sanskrit plays, Ratnavali, Naganand, Priyadarshika. The Buddhist bhikkhu Yuan Chuang had come to India from China. He stayed in India at Nalanda University for 2 years. After returning to China, he translated many Indian manuscripts into Chinese. So students, I hope this point is clear to you. Let us see the next point, 8.6, the power in Northeast India. Explanation: there is a story in Mahabharata where Arjun marries Ulupi. Ulupi was the princess of Manipur state in East India. The state of Kampur emerged on 4th century CE. It was established by Pushyavarma or Pushyavarman. His name is mentioned in the pillar inscription of Allahabad. Many inscriptions of Kamrup kings are available. You can Google it and see. In the epics like Ramayana and Mahabharata, the name Pragyajyotish is used for Kamrup. The capital of the state was Pragyajyotishpur. Today we call this place as Guwahati in Assam. There is a book named Periplus of the Arthurian Sea. Kamrup is mentioned as Kirhadia or the region of Kirat people. Kamrup kingdom extended in Brahmaputra river basin, Bhutan, some parts of Bengal and Bihar. During the rule of King Bhaskaravarman, Yuan Chuang had visited Kamrup. In this chapter, we learnt about different kingdoms in north of India after the Maurya period. Thank you.